My name is Sheila Marie McGlown, and I was diagnosed with breast cancer December 2nd of 2009. I was 43 years old, not thinking of breast cancer. So I just moved to a brand new home, and I was trying to make a E9, which is Chief Master Sergeant, but breast cancer put a hold on that, so. I was looking forward to becoming a Chief Master Sergeant in the United States Air Force because it was a goal of mine. It's a high accomplishment and it says a lot about who you are as a person. A black woman in the United States Air Force, I worked hard for that and you know that was one of my goals. Initially, when I was diagnosed December 2nd of 2009, I was diagnosed as metastatic. Stage 4, which I didn't know metastatic means stage 4. Stage 4 means metastatic, so I had to educate myself. And from there, my life just took a new normal. December 21st, I started chemo. I had to get a port and just so many things, you know, and I was HER2 positive. I didn't know there were different types of breast cancers, and I just had to learn. So my diagnosis, initial diagnosis, what they call de novo, and I've never been an early stager, and here I am. It was hard for me to accept it because my mom died of breast cancer. So she died in 2004, and then I got it in 2005. You know, what am I supposed to do without her? Because she is the only one that will understand. She was just resilient, you know, but the breast cancer just, you know, took over, and any day it could take over my body. So I get my strength from her and I love her for that, you know. My daughter, Janae Marie Glover, when I was diagnosed, she was 21. She was in college at the University of Toledo. And she wanted to come home, and I was like, no. Breast cancer is not going to stop you from doing what you're doing. I said, let mommy handle this. And because of my faith, I said, me and God, we're going to handle it. And 11 years later, I'm still fine. She has 2 masters. I said, no, breast cancer is not going to stop you from living. And it's not going to stop me from living. So my doctor's name is Dr. Cynthia Ma. She's great, she's my angel. And I go to Siteman Cancer Center down in St. Louis. I have been in a clinical trial since July of 2018. I had a 4th progression on my ribs. And she said, you can go back on standard, what you've been on, Taxotere, Taxol. But she said, I want you to try this clinical trial. And I said, sure, let's do it. 3 years later, it's still working. I'm still plugging along. I just wanted black women and men to see that it's okay to be on clinical trial because this is top-notch research. Like, they're not playing. I wanted people to see that, okay, if Sheila can do it and she's black and it's working for 3 years, then maybe I can do it.
I'm emailing her.
And I get loads of questions from black women. And I'm proud of it because, you know, not only am I contributing to research, I'm also basically saving my life.
Nice to see you too, thank you. And good luck at your doctor's appointment.
In 2012, I went to Living Beyond Breast Cancer's conference. I didn't know anybody, I was scared. I was like, man, are they gonna accept me because I have stage 4? You know, it was just so many things. But I also seen that there were not a lot of black people there or black breast cancer survivors. And I'm like, well, do black people not know about it? Do black breast cancer survivors not know about it? Okay, so I need to be an advocate. You know, I need to do more. And, you know, I took it back to my community and I took it back to everybody I know, and Living Beyond Breast Cancer, they listened. And since then, you know, it's been great. I think my advocacy work, it helps me survive. You know, metastatic breast cancer shouldn't just be talked about it on one day in October. We need to talk about it all year, every day. You know, cancer is not about Sheila, and it's never been about me. it's always been about who I'm gonna serve and help. And until God says otherwise, that's what I'm gonna do.